Hi everyone, welcome to S4 Shanya Science Classes. Today we are going to discuss about linkage and recombination. Before going to the topic, I would like to request you all, if anybody remaining to subscribe my channel, please subscribe and support me. We learned about chromosomal theory of inheritance in the previous session. Thomas Hunt Morgan worked with the fruit flies to prove the chromosomal theory of inheritance. He also carried out so many dihybrid crows experiment to prove the sex-linked inheritance about the linked genes. He actually selected the Drosophila melanogaster as a suitable material for genetic study because it has so many beneficial features. Some of the features are, these Drosophila can be grow on simple synthetic medium very easily. That means in the laboratory you can easily grow them. These are having very short generation time. उसका लाइफ साइकिल बहुत कम था, 12 टू 14 डेज ही है. तो यू कैन डू द ब्रीडिंग थ्रू आउट द ईयर एंड यू विल हैव इनफ प्रोजेनीज. आफ्टर मेटिंग यू विल गेट हंड्रेड्स ऑफ प्रोजेनी. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो हेल्प दम टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स और द जीन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, देयर बिहेवियर वेरी इजली. और इसमें मेल और फीमेल फ्लाइज को आइडेंटिफाई करना भी बहुत आसान था. मेल इज समवॉट स्मॉलर दैन द फीमेल. और यू कैन सी दैट it has many type of hereditary variation, so that can be seen with low power microscope. usko sirf 4 pairs of chromosomes tha, to usko study karna microscope with the help of microscope, it was really easy. because of all these character, Morgan have selected Drosophila as a suitable material for genetic studies. So here we are going to learn about linkage and recombination. What do you mean by linkage? Linkage is actually the physical association of two or more genes on a chromosome. Here I have taken an example, you can see here. These are actually a chromosome in which I have two genes A and B. So here, what is the chances of new generation, that means new combination? Here you can see that the crossing over will take place. If another chromosome, if I am taking here, you can see that. So the chances of the separation of these two genes are really more. So if the combination, the crossing over take place here, so this gene will be obviously separated. What about here? Here you can see that if the recombination, that means you can see that the crossing over take place here in between these, then these two genes, that means A and B genes, can be separated. What about here? Here you can see that the chances is really less if the crossing over taking place in between them, but that chances is really less if here there is no chance, because they are that much closely associated. This physical association is actually called the linkage. So from this example you can easily understand, the physical association of two or more genes on a chromosomes is called linkage. They will not show any independent assortment. According to Mendel, obviously the genes will show the independent assortment. That means they will be separate at the time of gamete formation. But if these are linked genes, that means whether they are closely related genes, they will not show any independent assortment. They will go as such. They will go together into the gametes. If you can see that the distance between these genes, if it is more, then there is more chances of recombination, new combination. What do you mean by recombination? The generation of a non-parental gene combination, that's called a recombination. That means jo parental gene ki combination kaun si hai, uske alawa kuch aur combination ban rahi hai. How it is actually forming? Because of the crossing over, or you can see that recombination, when the crossing over will be there, so in the new combination will have this gene separated and this gene separated, so they will be getting a different combination of the parent. So that's called a recombination. If the distance between these two genes are more, then there is a high chances of recombination. So that's actually, you can see that here. But if it is linked gene, that means whether the distance is getting reduced or less and less, then there is a less chance of recombination. The genes will as such will go into the next generation. That means the parental character as such will go to the next generation. I hope you have a clear idea, right? Now you can see one more thing here, the tightly linked genes, that means here this one, they will show very low recombination. Whether they are loosely linked, that means here it is not linked, they are really far apart, but if you are checking these one, these are actually loosely linked, that means more distance between these two genes. So we can say that loosely linked genes, then you can see that there is a high chances of recombination. Here also really that are far apart, then there is very, very high chance of recombination. Morgan carried out several dihybrid crows, from which we understand that linkage and recombination very clearly. What he have done, he have conducted so many dihybrid crows in Drosophila melanogaster. Usne yellow-bodied white-eyed female Drosophila ko brown-bodied red-eyed male ke saath cross kiya hai. And he got that a new combination. According to Mendel, it must be in the ratio of 9:3:3:1. This was the F2 phenotypic ratio. But Morgan haven't got that ratio. Morgan ko wo ratio nahi mila hai. What was the reason? He understand that he got only 1.3% of new varieties. Baki sare he got that white-eyed yellow-bodied Drosophila, which was the dominant character. तो उनको समझ में आ गई इसमें से white-eyed and yellow-bodied one as such offsprings में carry हुआ है. According to law of independent assortment, these characters can go and combine each other. Yellow-bodied, red-eyed के साथ, brown-bodied, white-eyed के साथ कैसे भी combination बना सकती है. But इनको ऐसे combination नहीं मिला है. If it is like that, then he will also get the ratio 9:3:3:1. But उनको वो ratio नहीं मिला है. उसकी मतलब he got that white-eyed and yellow-bodied as such भी मिला था. Most of the varieties was the same white-eyed yellow-bodied one. And very few new combination, that means the entire population he considered, 1.3% was that recombinant one. उसमें से उनको समझ में आ गई, these white-eyed and yellow-bodied genotype, the genes are actually closely associated. That means they are the linked gene and it is actually linked in the sex chromosome or the X chromosome. This is a X-linked gene. And it is carried out, when he carried out this cross, he got most of the varieties of the female variety, white-eyed and yellow-bodied. So he understand that this is a sex-linked or X-linked gene which is actually carried out in the female mainly. Right, and he also carried out white-eyed miniature winged Drosophila crossed with red-eyed large winged Drosophila. Here also you can see that the white-eyed miniature wing was the dominant character. According to that Mendel's law, here also he must be getting the ratio 9:3:3:1. But either be unko wo ratio nahi mila hai. Uski jage इनको बहुत सारी एंटायर पॉपुलेशन कंसिडर किया था उसमें 37.2% वाज रिकॉम्बिनेंट वन बट उसमें कुछ पॉपुलेशन वाज दैट एक्चुअली द वाइट आइड मिनिएचर विंग्ड वन उसमें से उनको समझ में आ गई दीस वर आल्सो द लिंक्ड जीन्स व्हिच इज एज सच कैरी टू द ऑस्प्रिंग्स तो इधर पैरेंटल कैरेक्टर हियर यू कैन सी दैट वाइट आइड एंड मिनिएचर विंग्ड here white-eyed and yellow-bodied which is the parental character which is the linked gene which are really closely associated so wo independent assortment show nahi kar rahi hai wo as such next generation mein ja rahi hai and very few that means they are really linked not closely linked very less distances here you can see that 1.3% that means these are really tightly packed right so these two genes are tightly packed to udhar new combination ki chances bahut kam tha But here 37.2% new combination ban gayi. So that means here these are linked, but they are actually loosely linked. That means if you are taking the chromosome, you can see here it may be like this, which is the X chromosome. Or iski case mein you can see that this may be like this. Here thoda sa linked hai, but they are loosely packed. Here linked gene hai, but they are tightly packed. So isliye new variation bahut kam tha. इधर न्यू वेरिएशन थोड़ा सा ज्यादा था तो हाउ मच डिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस दैट मच रिकॉम्बिनेशन विल बी देयर सो दिस वाज द एविडेंस ऑफ द लिंकेज सो वी अंडरस्टैंड द लिंकेज एंड रिकॉम्बिनेशन प्रॉपरली वी अंडरस्टूड दैट द टाइटली लिंक्ड जीन्स शो लो रिकॉम्बिनेशन एंड लूजली लिंक्ड जीन्स शो हाई रिकॉम्बिनेशन द साइंटिस्ट अल्फ्रेड स्टुअर्टवेंट यूज द रिकॉम्बिनेशन फ्रीक्वेंसी बिटवीन जीन पेयर्स for measuring the distance between genes and map their position on chromosomes. These maps are called genetic maps and these are used as starting point in the sequencing of genome in the human genome project etc. You can see there is a picture given in that you can understand some of the gene mapping. Here you can see that there are genes of body color,
genes of eye color and genes of wing size. Here you can see that the large distance between the gene of body color and the gene of wing size. So there will be a more chances of recombination, about 70% you can see that. Whether the distance is low, then there is a low recombination chances. So here you can see that the gene of body color and the gene of eye color, which is having very low distance, so the recombination chances is very low. Now you can see that the gene of eye color and gene of wing size, it is somewhat more than the distance between the gene of body color and eye color. So here there is some more chances of recombination. If the distance increases between the gene, then there will be a large chances of recombination. That means they are loosely linked genes. Whether the distance reduces, then the chances of recombination very less. They are tightly linked genes. I hope you understand this point clearly.
I hope you understand the topic very well. Thank you everyone. Thanks for watching.